Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. In the last part, Grunty was resurrected with the help of her sisters, and as a result, she wreaked havoc on Spiral Mountain and even destroyed our house and killed poor Bottles in the process. Oh my god, he's just a ghost now. Aw, poor Bottles, man. I can't believe they killed him. This is supposed to be a kid's game. Aw, man, poor guy. And if you've noticed from the last part, I've actually toned the volume down a little. I know in the intro is a bit too loud, and I can't really fix it because my Elgato is connected with my commentary, and by lowering one, it lowers the other, so it wouldn't have done a dang thing. But anyway, on with the game. Well, in this part, we're going to be visiting the little molehills right here, learning some of the moves we learned from the last game, brushing up on our skills, exploring more Spiral Mountain, seeing maybe what happens to that lair that we were in the last game. That was the main overworld. And going to that cave and seeing where Klungo went into, and hopefully put a stop to wherever he's planning. I doubt that there's that much because he's more of a henchman. He's not really an ideas kind of guy. But anyway, let's talk to this little molehill right here by hitting B. Alright, so basically, if you talk to this molehill, you get basic movements, camera controlling. We already know that. So let's move on, shall we? Let's see what's over here. I think these are the boots, the wading boots, and we have the running shoes, and that'll probably tell us how to do it. Basic jumping, turbo trainers, wading boots. Those are called the turbo trainers. I thought they were called the running shoes. My Banjo-Kazooie knowledge is being put to the test. And right here is the health from the game that we all know and love. Pick up honey to boost your energy. Whoa, okay, who was that? Was that like Terry Crews from the Old Spice commercials? Oh man, that would have been hilarious if it was instead of that head. But we'll be finding out who that is later on. And we got some eggs over here, which we fire with Kazooie. Tries using eggs as ammo. All right, Terry Crews in a military hat. Let's see if I can get him. Can I get him from here? How did I go that far? Wow, almost got to him. And if we go up here, we have another molehill. This is basically to tell us how to use the invulnerability feathers. Really have trouble pronouncing long words, and by doing that, we do LT and Bazamo. Come here. Come here. There you go. You made me waste a feather right there. All right, I get two from the groups of each time. So yeah, in this game, unlike the last one, the feathers and ammo and all that things are put together in one little neat little nest package, which is actually pretty convenient instead of getting them all individually one by one. So that's nice. So let's move on over here. We have some crates we can do. Go over the moves pretty quickly. I forgot to go over the most important one, which is my favorite, Talent Trot, which is LT and RT combined. LT first, obviously. And I'll be giving the Xbox 360 controls because that's what I'm playing on. And yeah, it'll be too confusing if I sit both. That and the N64 one. And to do what I just did, that's LT and X. And to fart an egg, it's LT and B. And to shoot an egg, come here. Oh man, that egg was too fast. And to shoot an egg, it's LT and Y. I'm firing it toward like Grunty's little indent over there. But yeah, there's nothing in the boxes over here. I don't think there's any empty honeycombs to collect this time around at Spiral Mountain. It's just more destruction and just more of a sightseeing kind of thing. But yep, we're in the hole that Grunty died. Wow, she really did a perfect belly flop for her body to indent like that. Jeez. And she was under there for 2 years. Wow, okay. I guess witches can't die. I don't know. I guess they're. Has something to do with their magic. Red feathers are needed for a Kazooie to fly. You got it, Commander. Let's see, what's over here? Yeah, I'm just briefly exploring Spiral Mountain. There's really nothing to do here. If you don't know any of the moves, that's the only reason that this area is for. Other than that, there is another useful thing about this area, which we'll be going up here. And what is this? A new item. And there we go, Grunty's lair entrance. Well done, you have found one of my missing pages. Collect 5, then return them to me in Grunty's old lair in Spiral Mountain. I should have done a more depressing voice than that. His eyes were kind of like, oh man. Because I think that was one of his pages that got torn out. I don't know, we have to talk to him to find more of the story. And that's the cave that Klungo went in. We're not going to go up there just yet. And over here is actually a waterfall. In the last game, we could actually go across it pretty easily, but seems that one of the parts got cut off and we can't access it. And in this little lake bed over here is a picture of Kazooie in a rock formation, which is pretty interesting. And just a thing to note, all the controls got inverted in this game. Up is up and down is down. Usually in the Banjo-Kazooie the first game, it was the opposite. I don't know if this is an Xbox 360 only feature or what, because normally I would do up would be going down and down would go be going up, like a flight control simulator kind of thing. But in this game, nope, up means up and down means down, go figure. But anyway, let's go up the famous Spiral Mountain. At least it's still Spiral, at least that's the only thing that didn't get damaged completely. It's like a landmark, it's like the Statue of Liberty, the Eiffel Tower, Spiral Mountain. 8th wonder of the world, or 9th wonder, I think there's only 8 wonders, or 7 wonders, I think there's 8. Oh god, an enemy over here. Kill him! Kill him! Oh god, I'm so sorry, that guy just got leveled. That guy's got jacked up. Let's see, let's just fly in here. Yeah, the bridge got kind of broken between the last two games, or in between the last game, I should say. It's only been one after all. And here we are, Grunty's old lair. It seems all run down. Grunty's been dead for 2 years now. Supposedly, as we found out in the first part, but let's talk to Cheeto, our old friend. Hello again, Banjo. Remember me? I'm Cheeto, the magical spellbook. Yeah, we know who you are. Just hand over something useful. You were out of luck there, I'm afraid. Grunty ripped out all my pages because I helped you in the last game. I'd be most grateful if you could look out for them on your travels. Maybe. What's in it for us? Well, for every 5 pages you return, I'll let you in on a little secret. You mean a cheat? Well, I'm not called Cheeto for nothing. That sounds like a pretty good deal. Sorry, but you'll have to find more pages before I tell you the new cheat.
Let's go find some pages, Banjo. I want a cheat.
Well, so do I, Kazooie, so do I, but alas, we only have 1 page. Every 5 pages gives us a new, cheat that we can use and access at a later date. We don't know how to access them yet, but we'll find out soon enough. Soon enough. Alright, so that's enough of the lair. There's actually one more little thing I want to show off in Spiral Mountain, and then we're done, basically. What you want to do is actually go over to this waterfall right here. It's not just the waterfall that shoots out normal water, but whoa! Okay, that was awesome. I got that right in the hole. Ah, but water goes down the hole, and we're behind the waterfall. That's a thing that's new to this game is whenever you go into a new area, they actually tell you what the area is, which is pretty nice, and there's one other thing that they add that we'll be seeing in probably a couple of minutes. But for now, what the hell is this? It's a Banjo-Kazooie cartridge. Basically, that is a stop-and-swap item. Who knew? But we'll be going over that later on, and we can't access it yet because we don't know that move. Oh well, we'll be learning that soon enough though. So without further ado, let's escape the cave. That's, I'm obviously being a little hesitant to go over what that stop and swap item is, and I'm doing that on purpose, but we'll be finding out what that is at a later date. Don't worry, I don't want to spend too much time here. We already spent about 8 minutes here after all, so I want to get on with the plot. So that's it, that's all we can do in Spiral Mountain. Not a whole lot, so without further ado, let's go inside the cave. Alright, whoa, god, my controller is vibrating inside the digger tunnel. That's another benefit of playing on the Xbox 360 version is the controller vibrates, and that's definitely an awesome feature to add to the game. Definitely adds a little more ambiance. And, oh god, okay. Speaking of ambiance, this guy's taking up a whole room of it. Alright, Klungo. You killed our friend, or a part of it. Minion with a mission. If it isn't the barren bird who caused so much trouble to Mistress Grunty. I don't recall anything like that happening. You is stupid. At least we can speak properly. Oh, Kazooie burn. Klungo is mad now. Your game ends here.
Whoa, okay, Klungo, easy. I'm sorry about pointing out your grammar. I'm sorry about being a grammar Nazi.
Grammar Nazi. That's irony right there. So yeah, Klungo smash. Basically, he'll grow big right here and start jumping around. And I got hit already. That was embarrassing. But all you have to do is just do a beat buster as an A jump with the X attack.
Clever Klungo hide behind magic shield. Now show Bear my special potion.
And for this little section right here, just all you have to do is just run around him and wait until his shield runs out, then do another pecking to him. So it's kind of like that second boss in Treasure Trove Cove, that all you have to do is peck his eyes out, but this one is just his body you have to peck. So, yeah, I wonder what's in these potions to make them dissolve like that. It must be acid or something. Klungo's taking a lot of acid, I'm sure, to make him have a speech impediment like that. But he is defeated. Not hard at all. And there we go, we got 3 honeycombs in case you lost some life there, and the entrances have opened.
Nasty barren bird hurts poor Klungo.
You asked for it. Why don't you run off and we'll forget this ever happened?
You're a good idea. But you not see last of Klungo.
Aw, poor Klungo.
Klungo coming, mistress. Please beat failure Klungo with broomstick.
Aw, he's kind of like the Pete of this game from Kingdom Hearts 2. He's like the laughable little minion that always gets yelled at and whatnot. Aw, poor guy. Poor little fella. And yeah, some things over here in case you lost health. There's a lot of honeycombs. They're really generous in this area, but I forgot to actually mention during the boss fight, I don't know why it slipped my mind, but yeah, there's many boss fights in this game that actually gives, like, the name of the boss, a little witty description, and that's just so cool. That's like, that is why, this is like the Kingdom Hearts argument. I like Kingdom Hearts 1 because of the nostalgia, and Kingdom Hearts 2 because of the gameplay. This is the same exact scenario. Banjo-Kazooie is great nostalgic, but this game is just, they crank it up to so many levels, they add so many new things to it. There's an actual overworld, not just confined in a lair, which is amazing. But I'll be going into my Banjo-Kazooie versus Banjo-Tooie arguments at later parts. I don't want to get into it now.
This is one of my silos. Open up some more to create a network of shortcut tunnels.
Yeah, fun fact, I didn't know what silos were until this game. Now I know. But then again, why would I have to know the situation of what a silo was? Like, you don't see those growing out of the ground anytime soon in our world, but yeah, we're in the Jinjo village. We got a greenhouse right here for the green Jinjos, the orange ones. Kind of always wondered where they lived. Oh my god, what happened here? Oh my god, the house is gone. And the tire tracks.
This is an information signpost. Press B when next to the one to read it.
Alright, what happened here?
In loving memory of the great Jinjo family, passed away unexpectedly when a huge digging machine flattened their house.
Oh my god. This game, like, the first two parts are just so dark. Oh my god. But this, it's funny how this game is incredibly dark in the beginning, but it's probably one of the funniest games of the series. And I only mentioned that's 1 and 2, I'm saying.
They're all gone. Come and see me in my throne room, and I'll tell you what happened.
Yeah, I want to give him like a sassy little voice. He's a king after all.
This is my palace, not bed, eh? Just come on in and see the Jinxster.
The Jinxster? Okay, that sounds like a derogatory term, but if you want to be called the Jinxster, I'll call you the Jinxster. But yeah, so basically, these are the Jinjo's houses. That's nice.
And what I was getting into is this game is just funny on so many levels. They really do a lot of fourth wall jokes. A lot more jokes than the first game. And that's why I like this game a whole lot, and this game just feels like a more, like, epic quest.
But anyway, I'm gonna actually end things off here because we took a lot of time exploring Spiral Mountain. I don't want to get into the next part just yet. I want to keep these parts 13 to 15 minutes because that's usually the preferred length of videos, and that's what I prefer to do. And yes, I'll end things off here, so if you like this part, drop me a like, be sure to subscribe, and I'll give you more of the things you love and play more of the games I love, so it's a win-win. So, in the next part of Banjo-Tooie, we'll be talking to that guy that likes to be called Jinxster, and we'll be continuing our quest, hopefully, avenge bottles and find out what the hell's going on. I see tire tracks there. We got a witch to catch, so see you later, guys, and until next time.